Diversity is being invited to the party. Inclusion is being asked to dance. I like it because that it makes such a difficult concept easy to understand. There's no emptier feeling than being invited to a party and then being left alone while everyone else has fun and mingles. In the workplace, inclusion means many things, but most importantly, it is an inclusive environment which is collaborative, supportive, and respectful. An environment that increases the participation and contribution of all employees. As a matter of fact, true inclusion removes all barriers, discrimination, and intolerance. I'm not sure how many of you heard Makhaya Ntini telling of his experience as a Protea cricket team member. He was invited to the party, that is racial diversity, the party being the cricket team. But he experienced exclusion. In his own words, he says, none of his teammates asked him to join them for after game or after practice activity, or even sit next to him in the bus. In other words, they would not dance with him. Thus, to me, in Vermeer's words, inclusion means dancing with a person that has been invited to the party on whatever basis and not necessarily invited by you. Slides. Next slide, please. In this world, as people and organizations, we have one big choice to make. That is to adapt or die. And in fact, the only control we have is how we react to what happens to us. We don't necessarily have control on what happens to us. People who cannot change or adapt soon find themselves irrelevant in the world. Take Nokia. In the 1990s and early 2000s, Nokia was what iPhone is today in the mobile phones. Kodak owned photography for decades. Where are they now? Zettafords, that sophisticated shopping elegance, missed the boat on the role of the digital marketplace in fashion. Super Ballistic, an online fashion shopping outlet, did not exist 2 decades ago. Apple hasn't been around for long, but they are dominating the mobile phone industry today. Nikon adapted with times. Telefunken, the TV brand from the 70s, but still standing because they kept changing with the times. COVID-19 has forced many of us to adapt to the digital transformation of Skype, using Teams, using Zoom. For the first time in my life, I delivered the company financials results in a virtual AGM and have had to chair board meetings via Zoom. If PPS was not willing to change and adapt, we would have experienced problems. Next slide. And next slide, please. An interest that organizations and youth have in common is advocating for the development of change drivers and youth leadership. Many organizations are tasked with creating opportunities that will empower young people with leadership responsibilities, enable them to drive change. Similarly, the millennial workforce looks for growth and leadership opportunities within organizations or networks they are part of. Mentorship opportunities are also vital. Next slide. In Mother Teresa's words, I can do things you cannot do. You can do things I cannot do. Together, we can do great things. This speaks to the idea of working together and dividing the work to reach a common goal or mutual vision. A case study that is quite close to home at PPS. For For a year, PPS management had been struggling with finding a solution to employee wellness. Now, to many of my age group, what comes to mind when we talk about wellness? We think about the gym, the exercises, and then we say, no, we don't have the money to fund a gym. And we are stuck in that paradigm. That's what I'm made to believe that was the situation at PPS as well. We have this fixed mindset, one problem, only one solution. Then came the young people who were pivotal in influencing change in the form of the PPS Young Leadership Forum. In 2018, interns that were part of the Graduate Internship Development Program proposed that PPS have its very first young committee forum that will be able to drive strategy with guidance and mentorship of group exco and senior management. With several nods of approval received from the pitch aligned to PPS Vision 2020-2022, the Young Leadership Forum was formed in June 2019. The YLF, as we call it, their role within the organization has also gone beyond the PPS walls because they were exposed to the teachings by the Thabo Mbeki African Leadership Institute, TIMALI. Through thought leadership ideals and African-centered epistemologies and methodologies, the YLF members are encouraged to accept the concepts to influence political, economic, social, and cultural renewal of the African continent within the various communities in which they operate. The organization gave the employee wellness challenge to the YLF. Fresh perspective, solve the problems within the budget. What was impossible became possible because management listened to the fresh perspective of youth, but more importantly, young people exercised their agency. Next slide. Next slide, please. Thank you. Are you that person who is able to command, to instigate, to succeed, or to even provoke? These individuals are often perceived as the annoying people within an organization. The ones who constantly push to make things better. When done right, the provocateur can be just the catalyst an organization needs to create real, meaningful change. When organizations and societies resist change, history has shown over and over again that it is young people that agitate for change and challenge the status quo. In our own country, young people, remember, many years ago, I was once young. These young people challenged status quo at different eras because they were fearless and had big dreams. There's nothing more powerful than a dream and a vision to drive change. When institutions refuse to change, it is the youth that will force the change by doing things differently. Next slide, please. I'm just going to hone in on the female perspective. I've spoken about the youth. Chris has shared with us the demographics of your industry, and indeed, women are very much underrepresented. Thus, this slide focuses on women in particular. In my profession as a pharmacist, we've been where you currently are as a profession. And on this part of my presentation, I'm going to reference my article that I wrote that was published last year. So those who have read it, I apologize. But those who have not read it, listen and you can read it afterwards. It is critical for professional women to have allies and supporters who understand their journey. You can't do it alone. Women working together to ensure a societal shift that encourages others to take their rightful place and contribute to South Africa's socioeconomic growth and development speaks to PPS ethos of mutuality and shared success. I am a product of women's support. I am where I am because of many, many women who carried me on their shoulders. Small gestures of support and affirmation convince us that we have as much right as the next person to be where we are. Your dreams are valid, and you are fit to take up opportunities and turn them into success. When growing in your career, remember to take stock of memorable milestones and the women and other people that propelled you forward. I wish I had known just what a change agent I was and I was going to be. Thank you. I wish I had known that it's not ability alone that counts. Everyone needs a helping hand. There may well be a glass ceiling where you are, but it's only glass and not concrete. Start plotting how to break it. Use every opportunity to engage with your seniors as opportunities for mentoring. People often ask me, who has mentored me and who do I mentor? My answer is always the same. Every interaction I have has provided me with an opportunity to learn and grow. And I see that as a form of mentorship. Next slide. As young, educated people, especially women, you have agency over your lives. You are blessed to be born at a time where you have real rights and equality. Just remember, with rights comes responsibility. We have many social ills in our communities, but you are the most empowered group of women thus far. Your role now is to empower others. Own your agency and be resilient. In conclusion, if you forget everything I have said, please remember just this one thing. Invite people to the party. That's diversity. But don't end there. Let them also dance, and even dance with them. This is what my colleagues at the Pharmaceutical Society did with me. Just to give you an example of that. When we started getting into the leadership structures of the PSSA, as we call it, Pharmaceutical Society of South Africa, we had a challenge of the language. We came in there and the meetings were conducted in Afrikaans. And we tried to say that let's have English as the mean the language of communication, at least officially, and we struggled to break through that class until we had a Bure Mesi who came in and said, I'm Afrikaans, but I think we should change into English. And that was the only way that things changed for the better, if I may say. She was prepared to dance with us, even though she had not necessarily invited us to be at that party. Similarly, at PPS, PPS did and continues to do so to this date. Initially, it was the leadership and management that danced with me. Now it's the young people that are doing it with me. They actually do make me feel very, very old. You will notice that today I'm wearing a bright red sweater because they have told me that my outfits are dull. They don't match the young people that I work with. So I have to change. And more is to come. They told us at a board meeting last week. You can teach them when I'm saying this, I'm saying this to you, to dance with the people that are at the party. You can teach them your moves, and they will teach you theirs, And in Mother Teresa's words, together you will do great things. Thank you all for listening to me and for the opportunity to engage with you through this platform provided by Sisters.